Hello again, and welcome back to another one. And today we have a couple of topics to cover, starting with one on the monthly report for the most viewed rappers in the world on this platform. And the win streak of the reigning champion comes to an end in October, and we'll get to more on this in a bit, as our old friend and former Eminem associate Aziz shared his thoughts on this report, and we'll get to this in a moment. Today we also have more from Britney Spears, and in her new book she brought up Eminem's horrorcore classic Kim from MMLP to explain what it was like when Justin Timberlake dropped Cry Me a River after they broke up in the early 2000s. And this has stirred debates online, more on this in a bit. And at the latter part of the video, we'll get to more from 50 Cent, who looks to have resumed his quote beef with Madonna, and her fans came for his neck in no time, but 50 Cent continues to fan the flames, as he had more to add after it made headlines, and I'll be looking forward to your thoughts later in the comment section. So starting with the most viewed rappers of the month, the latest report reveals rappers with the most views on YouTube in October, and for the first time in roughly 2 years, Eminem's been dethroned from the number one spot, and the top 5 goes Drake, Eminem, Doja Cat, NBA YoungBoy, and Future. And this change sparked reactions like, Eminem finally lost the YouTube race to Drake, it was a fun run, laughing emoji. Big rappers including Drake have all failed to take the number one spot even after they dropped huge projects in the 2020s. But it turns out the hated for all the dogs was the one to finally do it, but the fact that it was a 10 million lead still sparked surprises. Eminem must be stopped, loudly crying emoji. And believe it or not, in 2023, some people are still asking, who even watches Eminem in 2023, skull emoji? And while some have concluded, Drake got the boost from his new album, M shouldn't be doing these numbers with no album, lol. Rappers are in trouble when M drops, lol. But along came Eminem's former associate Aziz, who reacted, how ironic, he copied his style from me, a guy named Aubrey, just to be dethroned by a guy named Aubrey. The irony, laughing emoji, it'll forever be F white America for life.
Bathing in the tears of other rappers.
Moving on to the next point, Britney Spears recently dropped a new book, The Woman in Me, and many stories from the book have gone viral, especially stories linked to her ex Justin Timberlake, and an excerpt recently stirred discussions on Reddit when she cited Eminem's Kim when she spoke about Timberlake's single Cry Me a River and how it affected her, as while it portrayed her in a negative light, she revealed that Justin Timberlake cheated on her several times, and she added, there's always been more leeway in Hollywood for men than for women, and I see how men are encouraged to talk trash about women in order to become famous and powerful, but I was shattered. And she continued, the thought of me betraying him gave the album more angst, gave it a purpose, ish talking an unfaithful woman. The hip-hop world of that era loved the story with the theme F.U.B. getting revenge on women for perceived disrespect was all the rage at the time. Eminem's violent revenge song Kim was huge. The only problem with the narrative was that, in our case, it wasn't like that. Cry Me a River did very well, everyone felt sorry for him, and it shamed me. And some found it surprising that she thought Kim was huge, hence takes like, I don't ever remember Kim being huge back then, it wasn't like a smash radio hit or anything, it was more like a, yo, bro, have you heard this crazy song by Eminem yet? No? Listen to this on my Discman on the back of the bus. It wasn't huge on the charts, but was a huge topic based on conversations about music at the time. You could say it went viral for its time, since music fans around the world were shook by the song. And although Britney Spears believes Cry Me a River misled the public, since she pointed out how Justin Timberlake cheated on her multiple times, some believe she cheated on him. He made a song about it, nothing is stopping her from doing the same. Apparently, everyone cheating on everyone is pretty much Hollywood tradition, but in Britney's case, she believes Cry Me a River was one-sided. Thoughts? Moving on, 50 Cent decided to rekindle his quote beef with Madonna after videos of her recent performance at the O2 Arena hit the web, and 50 Cent shared this. Posted a side-by-side comparison with an ant and added a caption, eyes emoji. Who the F did this? She is rich. How the hell she didn't get it fixed? I want the effing doctor's name right now. I mean, damn it, man. LOL. 50 Cent and Madonna have had a hot and cold relationship over the years, and in this case, 50 Cent is trying to mask the diss as concern for Madonna and her fans came for his neck. It is very sad when a man attacks a woman and criticizes her body. Shame on you. Although some agree he ain't lying, it is just bad. But for the most part, 50 Cent's been getting dragged, and when it made headlines like 50 Cent mocks Madonna's appearance, compares her butt to an insect, 50 Cent reacted to the news, eyes emoji. Okay, so now TMZ is gonna act like they don't see her on stage looking like she just crapped herself. I scratch my head when I see a bad BBL. Where the F is the person's friends when they need them? She rich? She can fix it. Fix it. Laughing emoji, what the F, and he's still getting blasted. Why are you bullying a woman who is nearly 70? Although some believe 50 Cent is low-key the only one brave enough to say what other people are thinking. Yo, 50 Cent always says what everyone is thinking, laughing emojis. But what are your thoughts? 50 Cent still chose to play the quote, concern for Madonna angle, but two things can be correct, as he's also using it as an excuse to troll. Share your thoughts below. Thanks for watching and see you on the next one.